Hi friends, this is Dr Prathap. Today I'll be discussing about portal hypertension in this video. So portal hypertension, so what do you mean by portal hypertension? When the pressure in the portal system or in the portal vein, if it is increased beyond a certain limit, then you'll call it as portal hypertension. So what is that limit? That limit depends upon whether we are measuring it in millimeters of mercury or we are measuring it centimeters of water. So if you see, if it is measuring in millimeters of mercury, so hepatic venous pressure gradient, if it is more than 5 millimeters of mercury, then you will call it as portal hypertension. Or if you see absolute values in centimeters of water, if it is normal is 10 to 15 centimeters of water, if it is more than that, then you will call it as portal hypertension. So how this portal vein is formed? So this portal vein, it is formed by two important veins. One is the superior mesenteric vein and other one is the splenic vein. The splenic vein, which is draining from the spleen and also from the peripheral part of the pancreas, that is tail of the pancreas and the body of the pancreas. So this is joined by a vein called inferior mesenteric vein. This is the splenic vein. This is joined by an inferior mesenteric vein. They will go forward like this, and then this splenic vein, now it is joined by the superior mesenteric vein and forms the portal vein. This portal vein enters into the liver. So this enters into the liver. In the liver, it is broken down or it is divided into number of portal traps. It is divided into number of small venules going to the portal triads. So this portal vein, actually it drains almost every part of the GIT. This will drain from blood from every part of the GIT. Splenic vein, through the inferior mesenteric vein and through the superior mesenteric vein, almost entire GIT, it is drained by these three veins into the portal vein. When the portal circulation, when the portal pressure increases, this is called as portal hypertension. If you divide this if you divide the causes of portal hypertension, we can divide the cause of portal hypertension into three different ways. If the cause lies before the level of hepatic system or before the level of liver, we call this as prehepatic causes. If there is a problem in the liver leading to increased portal pressure, that is called as hepatic cause. If the problem lies after the portal vein, after the liver, so what is there after the liver? After the liver, all the hepatic venules that are coming from the liver, they are going and they are draining into the inferior vena cava. All the hepatic venules are draining into the inferior vena cava. From the inferior vena cava, they are going into the heart or into the superior, they are going into the right atrium. So if there is any problem in the inferior vena cava or if there is any problem in the heart, then that constitutes the post-hepatic causes. Post-hepatic causes. Now let us enumerate what are the causes of this portal hypertension. Dividing this into three important types. Number one, it is prehepatic. So when the cause lies before the liver, this may be in the splenic vein, this may be in the portal vein, or somewhere in the mesenteric veins. So the common causes for prehepatic portal hypertension are splenic vein thrombosis, number two, portal vein thrombosis, or three, massive splenomegaly seen in massive splenomegaly. So this syndrome is called as Balin syndrome. So now this splenic vein thrombosis or portal vein thrombosis, this can be because of any cause of thrombosis. This can be because of hypercoagulable state. This can be because of some trauma, local trauma in the abdomen, or this can be because of some stasis of blood in the portal circulation. So anything which will cause increased thrombosis in the body, this may lead to portal vein thrombosis or the splenic vein thrombosis. So the common examples are polycythemia or hypercoagulable states, Then the next thing is hepatic causes or hepatic portal hypertension. This is again divided into three different types. The first one is pre-sinusoidal. The next one is sinusoidal. And the third one is post-sinusoidal. So the sinusoidal cause for portal hypertension, which is the most important cause, most common cause, this is any cause of cirrhosis of liver. This can be because of alcoholic cirrhosis or hepatotrophic viruses like hepatitis B, hepatitis C, or metabolic diseases like alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, Wilson's disease, any other cause. This can be because of anything. So any cause of cirrhosis of liver, this is a sinusoidal cause. Pre-sinusoidal cause is which lies after the entry of portal vein into the liver before the sinusoids. So after the entry of portal vein into the liver before the sinusoids. So the most common cause are non-cirrhotic portal fibrosis, cystosomiasis, post-sinusoidal. So before entering into the IVC, after the sinusoids and before entering into the inferior vena cava. So this is because of hepatic venular obstruction. Hepatic venules, if they are obstructed. So hepatic venule or veno-occlusive disease. So this is called as hepatic veno-occlusive disease. Then post-hepatic causes, after the liver, the problem can be in the inferior vena cava or this can be in the heart. So the common causes are inferior vena cava webs in the inferior vena cava and Bacchiari syndrome in the heart. This can be because of constrictive pericarditis, restrictive cardiomyopathy. So these are the causes of portal hypertension. So these are the different causes of portal hypertension. So what happens if there is an increased pressure in the portal circulation? Now see, this portal circulation, this is going and communicating with that of the systemic circulation. So there are many points in the body where there is a anastomosis between the portal circulation and the systemic circulation. One very important thing that is seen is in the lower esophagus. So these are called as portosystemic anastomosis. They are present in many parts in the body. So most important out of this is the lower esophageal anastomosis. So which are the important cause for the variceal bleeding. They are also present in the free wall of the abdomen. They are also present in the liver also. So out of which the most important is the lower esophageal varices or the lower esophageal anastomosis, which causes, when the pressure in the portal circulation increases, when there is a portal hypertension, this causes the backflow of pressure into the anastomosis, causing the dilatation of the veins near the anastomosis. When these veins are more and more dilated, this leads to bleeding from these veins, that is called as variceal hemorrhage. So the clinical manifestations are the triad of symptoms that are seen in portal hypertension are, number one, the varices. Number two, because of increased pressure in the portal circulation, because of increased accumulation of the fluid in the periportal vein, this leads to increased hydrostatic pressure. So the hydrostatic pressure in the portal circulation increases. Whenever the hydrostatic pressure increases in a venule or in a vein, this leads to exudation of fluid from the vein into the extracellular fluid. So more and more amount of fluid is exudated, leading to formation of ascites. Number three, when more and more portal circulation or portal pressure is increased, the normal pathway of portal blood flow from the portal vein through the liver into the vena cava into the heart. This is not happening normally. So now the more amount of pressure that is increased in the portal vein, this should go back, and this will cause a congestion in the spleen, leading to splenomegaly. So this is the triad of symptoms that are seen in patients with portal hypertension. So varices, ascites and splenomegaly, these are the three symptoms or the triad of symptoms that are seen in splenomegaly. So this is about the pathogenesis or the causes and the clinical features of portal hypertension. In the next video, we'll be going to discuss about the ascites in detail. Thank you for watching. For more videos, you can subscribe to our channel, Conceptual Medicine by Dr. Prathap Bingi. Thank you.